Well, hello. Haven't been on for a while due to many things, one of which has been computer issues. Anyway, thought I'd get on and do a follow-up as to my new job. For those of you that have seen previous videos, you know that the end of May, I left my part-time position as a cake decorator at Publix. This was done, well, for a number of reasons, but one of them was too much drama, too much negativity, and I tried my best to stay out of it. And while I enjoyed the majority of the people I worked with, many of them were leaving to go on to other stores or leave the company. I had an instance back in December where a young gal that transferred to our store from another store. In fact, she had transferred twice to two different stores, and then we were the third because she had problems at each location. Anyway, she accused me of shoving or pushing her, which I did not do. And it made things very tense. We couldn't work together. Neither of us wanted to, and I definitely did not want to work with her, even though it was proven that the allegations against me, it was false. She was lying. But anyway, long story short, it came down to it at the end of May, after 5 months of them scheduling us not working together, they were going to have to shift her around to a different position in the bakery. And we were going to have to start working together, and no way. I was not going to put myself in that position. Management was aware of it. They understood, even though they were watching her very closely on cameras. I said, yeah, but you don't have audio. So, long story short, I made the decision to leave. I gave my notice. I left, and I have to say, it was a huge relief. But I was concerned about getting another job, because at my age, I'm going to be 73 in December. It's not easy. And I was probably being overly particular as to what I wanted to do. I drive an older vehicle. It has low mileage, but I want to make sure I can get to work. So I didn't want to drive too far. I want to work certain hours, basically, so that I can help assist with my granddaughter. A number of factors. So I applied to Target number one. I've always thought I love Target. And it's right next door to the grocery store I worked at, and I had become kind of friendly on break time with some of the people that worked over there. And from what I understood, it seemed like a good company. I could start there without taking a pay cut, which was also important. I applied at the local library, which I was somewhat disappointed, but I think it's an age factor. I only applied at probably 5 or 6 places. Target was my number one, and I first applied for an on-demand position and think where you pick up other people's shifts. And I thought, oh, that's a good way to get your foot in the door. See if you like it. You can kind of work when you want to. And I actually spoke with one of the HR people in that store, and he said he would watch for my application. So when I put it in, and then I didn't get selected, I was somewhat disappointed. Well, then I turned around and reapplied again. I made 3 separate applications. Boom, boom, boom. And you had to do video interviews. Well, lo and behold, they did choose me. Finally, and not for an on-demand position, but for basically, it's not a seasonal, it's a permanent position. I was given the choice of working as a barista in the Starbucks at Target or in what they call fulfillment. That's basically stocking the shelves. I really didn't want to do the Starbucks thing, and the hours weren't as conducive to what would work for me. So I selected the fulfillment. So anyway, long story short, the round, I think it was July 25th, that week, I went in for 2 days of orientation, which basically is 4 hours of talking with the HR man as he's explaining things, and then doing 4 hours of computer-based training. I was put on the schedule the next week, and worked with a lovely, lovely gal. And she works in the personal care items, which is like shaving cream and stuff like that. It's not cosmetics. But anyway, nice, nice woman. She lives here in Sarasota, and her husband actually has a pizza, two pizzerias. He just bought a bar in Venice where I used to live, which I was very familiar when she told me something about it. And not that I went there all the time, but I was very aware of the restaurant bar. And they are thinking of opening up a bakery. Anyway, really nice gal. And she told me that they were going to put me in housewares, which part of me was like, okay, I like all those things. But there's a drawback to it. Anyway, to get on with the story. Here I was thinking, they're not picking me because I'm older, but I actually think they picked me because I did meet the qualifications of customer service element. And it was really better being selected for a more permanent position than an on-demand. Anyway, I spent the first few days working with her, and we were going to, as a team, she was going to help me in this houseware section. But actually, I was able to go over and do it by myself. And so I'm in my, I think this is the fourth week. They have been scheduling me like 6 to 10 in the morning, 4 days a week. And I have to tell you, 4 hours is not hard. It's pretty easy peasy. And I like the early mornings because I'm used to it. And then the following week, it would be 5 to 10. This week, I was scheduled Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, 5 to 10. And I have to tell you, even though I have to get up an extra hour earlier to get in there at 5, because I like my lollygag time in the morning, you have a jump on your department. And basically, this is my department. The last 2 days, Monday and Tuesday, I'm filming this on a Wednesday. You may not see it for a couple days, but I'm actually filming it on Wednesday the 14th. The last 2 days, my team leader, that's what they call you, one of the management people, asked if I could stay and work longer. They are very accommodating to their team members. That's what they call them. They don't call them associates. They call them team members. And I said, certainly. So I did stay both days. Now, I didn't work full 8 hours. I worked 7.5 each day. I could have stayed longer, but I basically physically had enough. Now, I like it. The people are wonderful. I love, so far, the management people and the other team members that I've met or are working at the same time. One of the things I like the best is this is my department. They basically tell you what you're supposed to do, and then you go do it. You are working pretty much by yourself. So let's say I have a list of all these things I have to get done. My job, or the way I will be reviewed is on what I'm able to do. It will not factor in, let's say I'm doing really great, but I'm working alongside somebody that's a slowpoke or not so good. The beauty of working by yourself is you're measured and evaluated on your own performance, and I do like that. And I'm a type A, so I tend to push myself. Anyway, I like it. Now, the downside to it is, in housewares, it's not just all the little gadgets and the dishes and the pretty linens. We have refrigerators, you know, small ones, but and heavy microwaves and coffee pots and vacuum cleaners. So, for a woman my age, some of that is a little bit more physically demanding. My body's getting a little more used to it. I'm not going to list something that I know I can't do. And they are very good about giving you assistance if you need it. The other thing is, when you backstock items, you have to climb a ladder sometimes. It's probably, I don't know, 12 feet high, maybe higher. I am a bit afraid of heights. And you're supposed to hold on with two hands at all times. Well, if you're trying to lift something big up that ladder, There's no way you can be holding this package or this box and hold on with two hands. So that's a little hairy. But so far, I like it. I'm hoping that I lose a pound or two being so physical because basically the 2 months I was off work, not that I ate more, but I think the lack of real physical activity because it's hot here and in the summertime, I just hibernate. I can't stand the heat that much. Anyway, I can see it in my body. So I'm hoping some of this physical activity will get me back a little bit more in shape. And it's only in parts of my body, okay? I will tell you that they are the we had a storm here, a week or so ago here, and Debbie, and I've never seen flooding like this in the years I've lived in Florida. I don't know, I think it's probably 40 by now. And it was scary. And I did during this drive to work that morning because of being a brand new employee. Number one, I didn't even know how I could call out. And you can do it on your phone. You don't even have to physically talk to anybody. I found that out that day. But anyway, I went in. It was treacherous driving. I'm lucky I made it there. I got to the store, and lo and behold, here I am, having gone in all this storm. There's nobody in the parking lot. There's no cars. And I'm thinking, oh my God, did I do this for nothing? I got out of the car and I went up to the front door and I rang the alarm, the bell, so somebody would come open the door. Well, there was nobody in the store. But within 2 seconds, 2 minutes, one of the managers, my immediate boss, came up with another lady and we went in. I think there were only maybe that morning, at best, maybe four people. And then I think it grew to about seven. Everybody had called out. But what I'm going to tell you, and it's okay. I'm kind of kicking myself a little bit, but I went in, they thanked me for coming. I went and started doing what I knew to be done. Well, water started rushing in. One side of the building, apparently it must have been a roof leak or something. And I had gone into the back stock area and I was coming out with a cart. And all of a sudden, here's water, which I didn't see because I wasn't looking at the floor. Boom! I went down. Well, when I went down, landed on my rear end, but my left leg went under this cart and put a pretty nice gash on my shin. Got up, went another 2 feet, boom, down again. Well, that time when I went down, one of the other gentlemen, who's probably about my age bracket, came by, oh, and he helped me up. And then he radioed, Linda fell, Linda's down, Linda's down. Anyway, they came. As far as I was concerned, I was not overly hurt. Yes, the gash on my leg, I didn't think I was going to need stitches. And there was a little bit of a knot there for a while. I was soaking wet. My pants looked like, I had fallen in a river. And twice they offered to let me go pick out another pair of pants for free. And that's the only thing I'm kicking myself about. I said, no, I'm fine. I can work with wet pants. There's nobody here. Basically, customers weren't coming in. But in hindsight, it's like, Lordy, you could have had a free pair of jeans. And you should have taken them. It's not often somebody offers you something for free, but because they weren't damaged, they were just wet, I just thought I didn't need it. Anyway, long story short, that day I drove home, and oh boy, I'm amazed I made it home. I saw the flooding. I thought it would be better going home, but it was actually worse. And the one little major street I have to go down to get into the side street where I live, there were so many stalled cars. And I drive a Honda Civic, and it's low. And I prayed, I prayed, I prayed. I'm thinking, oh my goodness, these SUVs and stuff, they're stuck and they're stopped. And here I am in this low car. I hope I don't get stranded. number one. Plus, I was worried about damage to the vehicle as far as mechanically. I don't know what happens. I know your brakes can go out if you're in a lot of water. Anyway, long story short, the good Lord got me home and parked that car. Now, I did end up calling out the next day because where I had fallen turned out that the leg that I gashed was okay. I mean, it had a gash, but it was bandaged. But my other leg, I must have wrenched or pulled it or something and could barely put weight on my other leg. Anyway, I didn't hesitate. I thought, you know what? It's still flooding out there and I can't work like this. So they were fine with it and they realized. But anyway, the good Lord found me the job. And so far, so good. I'm not certain that I'm probably the best suited for this department, but I'm giving it my best shot. And sometimes, you know, we all know that if you change jobs or start a new job, the first couple weeks are usually the toughest. Now, I thought the first week or two were the easiest. I know I can do it. I'm proving that I can do it. It's just, can I sustain the lifting and some of the things involved? That's my concern. But I also think that if they like me and I prove myself, which I think to a point I've already shown that I'm a decent worker, that they may realize that maybe another department would be better for me. I don't know. But so far, I like it. And the nice thing is, I can go next door to the Publix, which now I'll openly say where I worked for before I didn't want to, and go in and say hi to people I know. So, all in all, good Lord took care of me. Now it's up to me, and I'll keep you posted. Along with this, I'm going to try and do a few more videos. I don't know what order I'm going to post them. I've had so many problems because I didn't realize my computer was storing everything. I have filmed multiple craft videos, but again, I'm having storage issues. So hopefully those will come up. But anyway, hope you're all having a good day. But I wanted to let you know that and give you the follow-up, which I had promised months ago. I didn't wasn't able to fulfill because of some computer issues. Anyway, wanted to touch base and thank you all that have hung in there with me and those of you that are new. Let's get to know one another. And in the meantime, have a great day and stay blessed. I love y'all.